Hey guys, Grady's mom here with a Target haul. I recently started using the Cartwheel app, which I know that I am super late to that party. For some reason, I thought it was something else, but I've been using the Cartwheel app. I really like it, and I think it's a really awesome way to save money on stuff you're gonna buy anyways. So let me go ahead and show you guys what I got. I spent about $130, and that is after I used Cartwheel. I don't know how much I saved on there, but if I can find my receipt, I will let you guys know. So I'm just gonna start grabbing bags. Alrighty, so I got two of the Annie's white shells and cheddar because I still haven't made it to BJ's. I usually get these in the 12 pack box at BJ's, which is much cheaper. So I just got two of those to hold me over till I can make it to BJ's. I got some lotion for my husband. It's the Gold Bond Ultimate Hydrating Lotion Men's Essentials. Looks like this in the pump top. It says it's for body, hands, and face, and it smells really good. It definitely has like a guy scent, and it just looks like that. This might be a good like stocking stuffer or something for your husband or significant other for Christmas. I have heard about this so many times. It's kind of hyped on YouTube. It's the Simple Brand Cleansing Micellar Water, and it just says cleanses, removes makeup, and hydrates kind to skin. So I'm going to kind of use this. Sort of like a toner. I just kind of want to check it out and see what the hype's about. I've used that brand before, but never that product. Next, I picked up a Burt's Bees Renewal Refining Cleanser with hibiscus and apple complex, and it says it gently exfoliates. I picked this up specifically for in the shower. I like to use just usually drugstore brand face cleansers in the shower. Why, I don't know. I tend to use my more higher end brands when I'm not taking a shower. So I picked this up to keep in my shower. I like Burt's Bees products, and this looked interesting, and it's definitely new. I've never seen it before. Next, I picked up three things for a friend of mine's daughter. Two things for a friend of mine's daughter. I'm not going to say who because she'll definitely watch this video, and I don't want her to know yet. That this is for her daughter. But anyways, I got this divided plate. It's BPA free and dishwasher safe, and it has like a little bear and an owl, and it says owl always love you. I'm trying to get the sticker off. Stickers bother me for some reason. But yeah, it's just a little compartmentalized plate, and it has the kind of rubber grippers on the bottom. I don't know how much it was, but I think it was like $3. And then I also got this little bowl that says somebody ate everything. And then around the rim, it almost has like a little tiny bit of a girly woodland creatures kind of feel around the rim. And then the bottom also has that rubber grip thing. So I thought these were really cute together, again, for my friend's daughter. This sticker's bothering me. I gotta take it off really quick. But yeah, I like that they're dishwasher safe because it's just easier to throw stuff in the dishwasher because I hate doing dishes. So that is for, again, a friend's daughter. In the same section, I also found this little cup for Grady. I thought this would be a good cup for brushing his teeth, like to rinse, you know, when he's brushing his teeth, because right now he's been using Dixie cups, and I find they're just a waste to use them and then throw them out. So I got him this little dinosaur tumbler cup. It's like a really small kid-sized cup, which is perfect to keep in his bathroom. And I like the little dinosaur theme, so that was really cute for Grady for his bathroom. Alrighty, next up I got a scarf, which I am obsessed with. I've actually been eyeing this scarf for a while. It is like a hunter green, navy blue, and black. And it's really kind of fluffy and full, like it's a big oversized scarf. And plaid is just so hot right now, and I've always loved plaid, so you don't have to convince me on that. It has a very light fringe, if you can see, and it's just a really cute scarf. I can't wait to wear it. And also what I do for scarves that are not infinity scarves, that I want to be infinity scarves, I just find the two ends and I either tie them in like a loose knot, or I use like a little hair tie, like usually a black one, and tie the ends, like fasten the ends, so that any scarf can be made into an infinity scarf. I just personally like the look of infinity scarves better on me, the way that they sit around my neck. So I picked this up. I thought it was really cute. This was $19.99, and it is, yeah, just a plaid green and navy blue scarf, and it's really oversized and kind of chunky. So I'm really excited to wear this all winter, all fall. Target women's apparel was 25% off. So I picked up this shirt for myself. It is so like silky soft. It feels like pajamas, but it's an actual shirt. It's just this sort of sage green sweatshirt, and it's a little bit higher in the front and longer in the back. And I just really liked the design on it, but mainly I fell in love with the fabric. It's like a silky smooth fabric. And I really like the sage green color. I think this will look really cute with jeans or leggings if it's long enough to cover my butt. And this was 25% off, and the original price was $19.99, so it was 25% off that. I thought that was really cute. And then I also picked up a shirt for Grady. I'm absolutely obsessed with Peanuts and Charlie Brown. I always have been. It's just like a childhood obsession of mine that's carried over to adulthood. So I picked him up this green, it's sort of a Kelly green shirt with the gray underneath it. And this is just, again, from the Peanuts line. It was $9, and I don't think it was on sale, but it was $9. And it's just made by Peanuts. It's like part of their, I guess, brand. And I did get a 5T because the 4T looked a little small, and he's just about to start getting into 5T. So I picked this up, and I'm thinking he can probably wear this now and all winter because it's really not all that cold here in the winter. And it's so cute. It says, "Don't stop believing." Forgot to mention that. Really cute. Moving on, I got the Goldfish lunch packs, which we already got into in Target, so I picked those up. I got a 10 pack of scented sort of Play-Doh. It's called Cento Scented Dough. It's like a party pack, and this I'm going to use for Grady's goodie bags for his birthday party, which is this weekend, so I thought that was a pretty cool little thing for kids. Just scented Play-Doh under a different name. Next up, I got some Pepperidge Farm soft-baked chocolate chip cookies. My son really likes these, so I like to give them in his lunch. I like to give him one or just as a treat, so I picked those up. These were on Cartwheel for 30% off. It's just the Up and Up brand disinfecting wipes. I actually do have some of these, but I figured this would be nice to put in my pantry or even send to school because we're going to be getting into flu season soon, unfortunately. So I might send these to Grady's school with him because his classroom always needs stuff like this. They're really, really big on sanitation and keeping everything clean. I got a 4-pack of the Smucker's Uncrustables for my husband's lunches. I got some Up and Up foaming tear-free baby hair and body wash. My son really likes being independent and like cleaning himself. He doesn't do the best job because he's 3, but I figured, he seems to like the foaming. So I got this sort of for him, not to really play with, but to let him sort of clean himself. And then we go ahead and do it again because he doesn't do the best job. He's 3. So I picked this up because I wanted something inexpensive because he doesn't really use it effectively, if that makes sense. So again, this was like $3.50 for this. This is a huge 28-ounce bottle. That's why I picked the generic up. I do like the Up and Up brand in general, but I figured if some of it ends up wasted because he doesn't clean himself as effectively, I won't feel as bad because I didn't spend a lot of money. I hope that all makes sense. But yeah, this is what I got from the Up and Up brand. I also got this dish soap in the Freesia. I've never seen this scent before. I don't know if it just came out or something, but I'm really excited. I twisted the top off to smell it. It smelled really good. And I'm obsessed with the Method dish soaps. I think they're just the best. I love them. So I'm excited about a new scent. And then, last bag here, I got some Mott's fruit snacks. My son is kind of sick of the Annie's fruit snacks. He's been eating those literally for the past couple years. He's kind of sick of them. So I picked the Mott's original fruit snacks up, and he seems to like them because it's something new. I got some K cups. I got some dark roast, I think. Yes, French roast, dark coffee for myself. This is the McCafe McDonald's French roast, which I actually happen to like the McDonald's coffee. I get it every once in a while in the drive-thru. I think it's like $1 for any size. So I picked this up as well. It's an 18 pack. I also picked up for my husband the Green Mountain Pumpkin Spice K-Cups. This is his favorite. He really doesn't ask for much, but he specifically asked me to get him pumpkin spice coffee because they soon probably won't be making it anymore until next year. It tends to be like a fall seasonal thing, so I got a box of this. I probably should have gotten 2 because I don't know how much longer it'll be around. I'm assuming it'll be around for November. And then lastly, I got a Christmas present for my mom. It's a book called After Alice. It's a hardcover. They didn't have a paperback. I actually would prefer to get the paperback to save a little money, but they didn't have it. It was sold out. This is from the New York Times bestselling author of the book Wicked, which my mom really liked that book, and she actually saw Wicked on Broadway and loved it. It just says a novel. I'm assuming for some reason it seems, yes, it's based on Alice in Wonderland. It's based on that story. And it got good reviews. My mom is a huge bookworm, so this will be a really nice gift for her. I'm just hoping she doesn't have it. I don't think she does, and I think, pretty sure it just came out, but I could be wrong. So yeah, if anybody's read this, I would love to hear your input if you liked it and if you know if it's new or not. I recently just started seeing it the past month, so I'm assuming it's new. But yeah, this is what I got from my mom, and that is everything I got from Target. Let me see if I can hunt down my receipt. Yes, I spent $131 and I saved, I don't think it told me how, I'll figure out how much I saved and I'll insert it if I can remember to. But, oh, it doesn't tell you the amount, it just says saved 30%, saved 25%. But regardless, I saved, I'm going to guess about $15 to $20 total from everything. So I hope you guys enjoy the Target haul. Have a great day and I will see you all very soon. Bye guys.